Thank you very much and welcome everybody. I'd like to welcome everyone on behalf of INCLO, the International Network of Civil Liberties Organizations, and my organization, FACS, or ACLU, and also on behalf of the Justicia. This event was co-organized by these three organizations. I would like to focus on the Grainy Ground manual that is only available online, that you can find this brochure on your table. The Grainy Ground manual addresses the all too familiar phenomenon, the shrinking civic space, from a very practical point of view. So our aim was to, can you hear me like this actually? Okay. So our aim was to collect and organize the different threats that civil society organizations face around the globe, and also provide practical answers to them. Collect all the good practices that are available in a manual and provide that to civil society around the globe. So the global trend to shrink the space for democratic dissent is a phenomenon that we are very familiar with. It encompasses regulations to restrict foreign funding for NGOs, but also smear campaigns attacking the credibility of civil society organizations. It doesn't only affect civil society organizations in the registered and formal NGO form, but our assessment found that it very similar tactics are used against people who dissent in the countries that it's prevalent. According to the Civicus Monitor tracks the changes regarding civic space globally, regionally, and nationally. So according to the Civicus Monitor in 2017, 109 countries have closed, repressed, or obstructed civic space. That means that 82% of the world's population live in a country where civic space, space for dissent, the space for active participation, is somehow obstructed or even closed. So this is the phenomenon that we addressed in this manual, and we identified five types of threats. One is the new and restrictive reporting regulations. We are familiar with this from our 2017 anti-NGO law that requires organizations to publish on their website and on their publications that they would be foreign funding. And the different tactics that we address are organized under the name to comply or not to comply. There are different approaches to that, whether you comply with the excessive reporting regulations. The second threat is the interference with NGOs and the intimidation of staff. How do you respond to that? And one response is the enhancing the digital security of the organization or within the organization. And the third threat that we identified is arbitrary legal action and providing foreign funding. So in the manual, we discuss forming alternative organizational structures that allow organizations to mitigate this type of threats. The first three threats are more of defensive nature. They are more inward looking. They are more focusing on how to protect yourself. While the fourth and the fifth threat and the accompanying tactic is more forward looking, is more looking about how to solve the situation and reflect on our practices, and also it builds on the ability to learn from mistakes and understand the possible shortcomings of the civic space or the civic sector. So the fourth threat is called NGO sector wide assault. And the possible answer to it is forming alliances. One of the case studies is from our Kenyan partner in INCLO. They managed to form a coalition that not only joins organizations from the civic space, from the civic sector, but also faith-based organizations and organizations from the private sector. So the Kenyan Human Rights Commission managed to bring together all these different type of organizations and catalyze the authoritative regime and its activities as state capture. They also say that the memory of a former repressive regime helped them in addressing the situation and forming the alliance. So the memory of a former repressive regime was helpful in bringing together all these different type of actors and develop the state capture narrative that helped them to hold some of the proposed regulations. And the fifth thread, and that brings us together, brings us closer to the topic of today's event, is about delegitimization. Delegitimized through claims of foreign funding and no local constituency. This basically touches on the legitimacy of the organizations and the legitimacy that is coming from the symbolic power of civil society, the power that that civil society organizations have are not an economic power, but it comes from our values, from our moral, from our mission that we are standing up for the vulnerable. This threatens this very legitimacy that is coming from that. So a possible answer is reshaping public perception and building constituency. And let me give one of our examples at ACLU about the possible way to address this threat. In the wake of 2017, when the very harsh anti-NGO campaign started and the government proposed the bill on foreign funding organizations, we started to develop a new campaign called the ACLU is needed. At the beginning, we really used this hashtag to communicate about our success stories, but it quickly became a comprehensive communication campaign in which we wanted to lay out our values, show who we are and what we believe in, and also the clients that are reporting about why they need the ACLU, why the ACLU is important for them. So this also feeds into the discussion about reinforcing the human rights narrative, explaining the values that we have in a very easy to understand format. I really like the word relatable, because oftentimes the human rights movement uses abstract, legalistic language. And in this campaign, we attempted to use a much more plain language. We use language that doesn't refer to legal terms or terms that are not easy to understand for average people, like rainbow families. Instead, we use the word, or we use the expression, families or children whose parents didn't marry. So, and that was really powerful on the one hand. And on the other hand, not only the other. So we showed an elderly lady who fought local corruption in her town, and we showed families who suffered from poverty. And this reinforced our message and allowed us to communicate that human rights and the values that we are standing for are for everyone. And we will continue with this discussion about communication in the second panel. So I will stop here, and I just wanted to give you an example from Hungary to show that there is also some thinking about this. And finally, just few words about INCLO, because I forgot to talk about it. INCLO is a network of 13 national independent civil liberties and human rights organizations from around the world working to promote fundamental rights and freedoms. The Justicia and ACLU are members, but also the Kenyan organization that I mentioned. And we came together to bridge our local work with the international work, and one of the outcomes is the manual that I discussed. Thank you very much.